The city of Azusa is one of the best places in California to live, work, and play. And as the demand to live in our city grows, it's time for us to have a conversation about housing. California law requires all cities and counties to have a plan for how they will meet the housing needs of everyone in the community, no matter their income level. That's why we've launched the Azusa Housing for All initiative, a clear plan and a dynamic framework for how we will meet our housing needs together as a community. When the state's 8-year population forecast gets revised, cities like Azusa need to update their housing plans to address these new projections. Now, some of you are probably thinking, what if we don't want to build more housing in Azusa? That's an understandable response. But before reacting, let's break it down, because there's actually a lot of reasons why it's important to meet our community's housing needs. Because of the high cost of housing, it can be challenging for cities in the San Gabriel Valley, like Azusa, to provide enough affordable housing for groups like seniors, families, and young professionals. Lack of affordable housing makes it more difficult for children that grow up in Azusa to stay in Azusa as adults. More importantly, lack of affordable housing can also lead to overcrowding, increased homelessness, impacts to healthcare, and increased costs to the community. Having housing options for all not only helps fulfill Azusa's housing plan, but ensures high quality of life for all our residents in the future. So, what happens if we don't get a new housing plan approved? Well, the city could be fined, lose state funding opportunities, lose the ability to issue permits, and in the end, not have a say in where new housing should go. So how many new homes are needed? Based on the state's forecast and the local housing formula, Azusa must plan to add 2,651 new housing units by October 2029. And of those 2,651 units, 1,128 need to be affordable to low and very low income households. The updated housing plan must show the exact location where future housing can be built and how many homes can be built at each location. But how do we decide where new housing should go? And what are considered good places for new homes? Here are a few appropriate locations where housing or density can be added to meet our community's needs. Vacant lots that have not been set aside for open space. Sites that are either underutilized or in need of rehabilitation. Locations where housing could become denser than it currently is. Areas near public transportation and essential services like healthcare, police, fire, and retail centers. And places where housing could be added to retail spaces or business parks, creating new live-work neighborhoods. Some cities, including Azusa, may also encourage homeowners to build mother-in-law quarters on their properties. These are called accessory dwelling units, or ADUs. But before we decide what goes where, we need your help. We want to know what's most important to you when thinking about where new housing should be located. This is an opportunity to move Azusa forward and work together to make sure the Housing for All initiative is a success. The decisions we make in the coming months will shape our community for years to come. So let's do the best thing for our city and make them together.